Hello, my name is Joel Santana, and I am a character designer and concept artist. And today I'm going to share with you what my favorite digital painting brushes are in Photoshop. All right, so let's take a look at brushes here. I have quite a variety that I enjoy using. To be quite honest, me personally, I kind of stick to two or three brushes. And the more that you talk to other illustrators, you'll find that they probably do the same thing. But I'm gonna share with you just a handful that I have used, just so that you can find one, hopefully, that works for you. So starting off with these brushes here, they're by this artist called Loish, L-O-I-S-H. You can look her up on Instagram. She is awesome. She's really, really talented. So I really like these brushes. I use them a lot. She has this one right here. It's called the Oil Pastel. It gives you a really nice textured effect. So as you look at that, look at those edges. Look at how cool that is. And then if you turn on these options here on Photoshop, you adjust kind of like the pressure sensitivity. And then also this option here, it gives you it lets you build up the brush. So if you see this here, you see how soft that is? And then the harder I press, you see how that gets nice and dark? Very, very cool. So I love, look at this, the edge on this brush here. Now watch when I switch over to her hard round brush. So this one, you could also get some texture, but it's gonna have a softer edge to it. So I'm gonna bump up the size of the brush here, and now watch that. So see, it's soft, it's a soft edge, but you could still build up and create some really nice textures. Let me change the color a bit. So say you were painting, a face. You know, you could have your color here, and then even though it's a soft edge brush, it still gives you some interesting blending and texture. So this is one of the reasons why I like this brush too. So a lot of times the brush that you use, it's not about using cool effects and making it look cool like that. It's more about what are you trying to paint? Are you trying to paint skin? Are you trying to paint hair? You know, think about those things when you choose your brush. Don't just pick something because it's trendy and a lot of people are using it. Use what's gonna work to create the best illustration that you're trying to achieve. So let me create a new layer here and move on to another set. She has Loish, once you check her out, she has a bunch of other brushes, so feel free to check those out. But I'm gonna move on to this next one. These are by Kyle Brushes. And he actually, if you have the Adobe Creative Suite, it comes, he has a bunch of brushes that comes with the suite itself. So he aside from that, he does have some other ones that you can find out there, but he has a ton of options. This one is from Kyle Brushes Mega Pack. So let's pick this one. This is one of my favorite drawing brushes. It's called the Drawing Box Animator Pencil 2. And so with this one, let me change the color here down to something darker. What I like about this animator pencil is you get some nice variety in lines, but it feels very, very natural. So as you start to draw with this, I think this is for people to, a lot of times I get asked, you know, are your drawings, you know, on paper or do you draw on the computer? And I do love to draw on paper. I kind of prefer it often, but with this brush, you know, once you get used to it, I mean, it really feels like something that you draw on paper. It feels very, very natural for drawing. It's very easy for blending. Your lines feel very smooth and organic. So again, just one of my favorite brushes for drawing. Let me use another one before I move on to the next set. Let me use another good one that he has is this Perfect Pencil. So the Perfect Pencil 2 by Kyle, though this is a really nice brush if you're trying to blend. So if you're trying to go for that graphite, you see how rough that is? And then it blends. So this is really good for shading. It gives you a really nice effect. And this one, even more so than the animator pencil, this one really looks like charcoal, like graphite on textured paper. So this one looks really, really natural. So between those two brushes, if I'm sketching something on the computer, it's more than likely that I'm using one of those two brushes. So definitely check those out. Let's move on to the same thing from Kyle. He has another set, and these are from the paint box. He has a paint box set. It has a bunch of brushes in there. I'm gonna use the Gouache Agogo. So I'm gonna change it to this blue color here so you can see something. I'm gonna turn on this pressure sensitivity. I'm gonna turn this guy on here too. And this one is similar to Loewish's textured brush. It's very similar to it, but it feels a little bit softer, like a little easier to blend your colors. So as you see that, and I kind of bring this other color in, you see the buildup is a lot more subtle. So I like this brush a lot. Again, very similar to the other textured painting brush that I showed you, but it has enough of a difference where depending on what I'm doing, I might use that one as well. So that's it for Kyle. And again, he's got a ton of brushes, but I'll use this last one. I'll show you this last one by Lin Chen, if I can find her in here. Okay, here she is. And let's see, this soft texture brush is yet another one. She has a lot of special effects brushes, but I'll just use this one. And same thing with this one, a nice texture, but it feels a little bit more pastel-y, if that's a word. I'm not sure that that's a word, but it is for me. So a softer blend, but just a very subtle texture edge to it. So those are all the brushes I wanted to share with you today. Again, try to make sure that you use one that works for what you're trying to work on. Don't use trendy brushes. I mean, they're fine to use, but when you choose one, make sure that it's what you need for the illustration. Best of luck to you. Okay, I hope you enjoyed that demo. I do hope that one of those brushes fits the style that you work in, so please feel free to try those. If you have any questions, subscribe to this channel, and feel free to check out my course on Domestika.